Welcome, Ms. Pragati, to the interview for Invincible Publishers. It was a pleasure having you. I'm much obliged to have you here today. Can you tell me something about yourself?
Okay, so, well, there's lots that I've been able to achieve for in last 20 years, but to just make it crisp and short, let me tell you, I am a certified psychologist, and I'm also a personal growth and transformation master coach at a counseling and training solutions company by the name of EduConcepts India Initiatives.
So when you're not being a psychologist, when you're not helping people, what do you do?
I help myself. That means I engage so much in self-soothing, in just lying low and recuperating and bringing on a lot of energies in myself, because that's what I'm supposed to give out to the world. Secondly, I am playing with my dog. That's one of the most beautiful part of my life. And yes, I have two kids and a family, beautiful little family. So that's what keeps me busy.
Yeah, even I have a cat, and it really calms me down when I'm, you know, agitated or something. So I get where you are coming from. Now with this book, now you are on your journey to be an author. With this book, tell me something about this book of yours.
Okay, so if you're aware, this is my second book. My first book was just a pilot testing. It was more like testing the waters on how something like this would be taken up. Mm-hmm. And I was very happy with, though it was a very small, we called it the Ultimate Handbook of Parenting. Mm-hmm. And it was indeed a handbook, which means a very simple little reminders for the parents of what could be taken care of in real life. And just a tweeny-weeny, you know, the action plans towards it. That's what I kind of started off with. Mm-hmm. And I really wanted to understand how this was, being taken. And I got such rave reviews. People loved the whole idea of something like that. And that gave me the courage to write my second one, which is all about raising the parent. And if you look at the title, all this while people have been telling me, raising the parent, are you sure? Isn't it about raising the children? Mm-hmm. I said, no, children are doing wonderfully well, whether it's our kids, our young adults. I'm super impressed with this generation, the way they are doing, the way they are achieving. So, and you know, by virtue of my work, I work with a lot of them. And I realized it's high time that a parent needs to focus on themselves. True. All the time, their eyes are on the children, on the young adult or things like that. But they forget that any house or any office or any place where they are being a nurturer, it actually drops from top to bottom. It's never the other way around. So I thought it's a good idea to remind them. So I totally respect the intelligence of our readers, and keeping that in mind, mm-hmm. I just wanted to write something which was a reminder from one sane parent to another, from one sane professional to another. And that's how I came up with this book.
Yeah, because in India, the traditional parenting is like either complete neglect, like just leaving them around and let them grow up however they want to, or punishing them with, you know, hard pads. Like, this is all Asian parents, I think. Like, we get fatkaud every time, you know, a kid does something. And the first thought is not explaining to him what he did wrong or why he is getting punished. The first thing is slap or something. Like, this is a normal Indian thing that we have grown up like that. I mean, my parents didn't do that to me.
I would not say that. I'll tell you what. So many times the parent doesn't, they don't have the time sometimes. So time is one big thing, which is actually,
especially in joint families.
So it's not just about Asian. I would say it's culturally happening all over the world that parents are getting busier by the day. Mm-hmm. And when they become a parent, the other aspect which spoils the game for them is power struggles.
Yeah.
All they want to understand is, I am the parent. If you're not listening to me, you better move out of my house or things like that. So from there, all that, I would say confrontation and confusion and all this chaos, it actually starts from there. So it's high time a parent needs to reconsider how they are kind of managing children, how they're balancing it, how they're disciplining it, and simply how they are just being around them. That's
maybe researching something about the kids. Like, as parents, they're new, you know, and there's a saying, that the first child is the experiment. Like, you experiment all your parenting tricks on the first child, and the second child gets all the boon, all the benefits of the first parenting experience. So
I think even that's not for sure, that that's a very, you know, that's also not a proven strategy. What I've realized is a parent is happiest to talk about what is wrong, what is not happening, how it has to happen. They don't want to learn anymore. They cite, oh, time nahi hai, you know, those kind of stuff. So whether they don't have time, whether they're stressed on their job, and or they feel, no, I know enough. What do you mean? I don't know all these years. What have I done? So I have a complete chapter in this book, which talks of you may, you know, grow in your work. You may grow age-wise, but that's not a sure-shot way of gaining wisdom. Wisdom is when you learn about a few things, when you know how this is going to progress, how your child is going to develop. So I don't think parents have much knowledge about developmental thing, but you'll find a lot of parents writing comments like, oh, mothers knows best. Mothers knows best. But then if the mother is, you know,
actually engaged
with the whole process of parenting. There are a lot of mothers who are so busy cooking, and by the end of the day, the child wants to talk. They will tell, oh, come later. So these kind of things actually spoil the whole connection, as you said.
Yeah. Even nowadays, I think there is a trend of parents who, like, they won't hit the child. They will try to, you know, be very polite with the kids. And it's a good thing to be polite and to explain things to the children. But the children then take it for granted. They have this, you know, that I am the boss and not my parents are the boss. And so, and if, you know, like if the kid is asking, questions or, you know, troubling them, they'll just give him the phone, like take an iPad, take a phone, just don't eat my head or something like that. And so does this book help parents to guide their way?
Correct. That's happening really sporadically. I'll tell you what, though, yes, whatever you've said, it's equally disturbing. Like, I've seen a lot of young children glued into their parents' cell phone while they are, you know, out, whether it's a marketplace or it's a restaurant, you'll find this very commonplace thing. Yeah. And I feel so, you know, pissed off with this whole idea of what are you doing? Exactly. Please stop this. And you can't say anything. That's another. But then, what I've tried to cover in this book are two things. One is I totally believe that hitting a child is absolutely non-negotiable, because once you reach that pinnacle of punishment, there's nothing beyond that. So that should be your ultimate. When nothing else works, that's the time you go there, right? Though, say, please don't go there. That's no criteria, because you're not even hurting the physical power of the child, but even the emotionally, you're kind of creating scars. So I have a daughter who's turning 24. I've never hit her, and I take a lot of pride in that. And when I can do it, my idea of writing this book about the whole thing is, if I can do it, even you can do it.
But that's also an exception.
That's a strategy. Look at this. That's a strategy
that might not work for everyone. Right. I mean, it's a general strategy that you can go through. That's a guide. It's a guide that you can use.
No, I'll tell you what. If your connection is missing, this will not work. If your empathy is missing, this will not work. If you've not worked on the base foundational levels of the child, this will not work. So there are precursors and pre-reasons to it. And that also I've mentioned in the chapter. So if you're found, you know, rapport is good enough, I don't think your child won't listen to you. Yes, you may have to remind a couple of more times. And I think parenting is all about patience. That's the second word. So parenting is patience.
And patience is something very few have in nowadays.
All of us, we are missing it out these days. Look at everybody's patience. I mean, it's going down each passing day. So yes, I guess this book would be a very good reminder on how connection, patience, and all these little foundation elements. So my idea is to just remind them and tell them that's not deal. Secondly, as you talk about the gadgets, I have also talked about one complete chapter only on internet, on YouTube, on addictions.
Social media.
Oh, yes. Because children do have phone these days. And last 2 years, I've had so many cases where anxiety in children has gone up. They're not sleeping. Yeah. They're overusing their gadgets. And they are even, you know, the parents are just not happy with the whole trend, because it's diverting from study all to, you know, just the usage of gadgets.
Yeah,
we
see so many kids. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm cutting you off over here.
That's okay.
So many kids, like on Instagram, like 6-7 year old kids or 2 year old child, parents are posting photos, and they have their personal Instagram handle, which they get later around when they're 10 years old, something. And then I am seeing 8-9 year olds having gameplay YouTube channel where they are posting gameplay. But okay, it's gameplay now. Someday later, it would be something else. You are already making them, you know, exposed to a lot of things. We can't control the internet. The internet is a vast amount of gutter where there's good things as well as the bad things. And we can't have, you know, manage that. We haven't come up with an app that controls anything like that right now. So there's a lot of exposure.
And let's not forget, children are so curious. Look at this. Children are so curious. Once you give them something like this, which is so deep, they would like to explore. They would like to find out where this goes. And this is happening when children are watching a lot of stuff or consuming a lot of stuff, which is not age appropriate.
Yeah.
This is what is happening. And a parent cannot be expected to sit at home and watch them all the time. And there's a limit. So, you know, a lot of time parents say they've grown up, so they have to understand this. Trust me, when it comes to all these enticing stuff, none of us is grown up. None of us. So many of us, even we go berserk when we are on social media, right?
Yeah.
Facebook. And there are ample apps available. So your apps are right there on the phone. It's just a, you know, a click that it takes you to the another world altogether. And I guess that's also the reason why children are having social anxiety, relationship managements are dysfunctional. A lot of things are happening. So my concern about all this actually culminated into this book.
So this book is definitely a guide. You need to read this book. It will help you take care of your children or maybe be the person that you want to be without being
Honestly, I want the parent first to take care of themselves. Because it is all in the environment. If it is not there in the environment, it will not happen. So a lot of time parents would say, no, we have tried everything. We don't do all this. It's a reality check. You know, you've got to sit down calmly and reflect. Where is this coming from? If there's something happening in your family which you don't like, it's possibly around somewhere there or in the extended family or in the peer group. So you need to check. And I guess when you remind them on, I've put some 21 reminders here. I say life is a game. You've got to play it well. And to play it well, you need to know the rules. And that's exactly what I have put up. I put up a lot of action plans through psychology, behavior design. And, there's a science called NLP, neuro-linguistic programming. So I've tried to build up so much through that. So because unless you know how this has to be handled, you will be handling it in different ways and possibly even spoiling it.
True.
So, and then once you spoil it, you take it to a psychologist and the psychologist goes crazy. So I have seen people go to psychologists only in extreme cases, or they come to us when the things have totally been spoiled.
Yeah.
And then they are in a hurry. They lose patience.
They want the quick actions. They want quick reactions and quick recovery or something like, you give the pills and bam.
Yeah. Totally. It doesn't happen like that. What they're trying is they want to sort it there and then. And because it didn't develop in a day, it'll not go away in a day. As simple as that. And that's a sheer common sense logic. You know, something that doesn't develop in a day, it doesn't go in a day. And it's a matter of a very active human being engaging in those behaviors. Yeah. So unless you get a rapport or a connect, how would you even be able to transform it? I have my doubts.
Pragati, as a final question, I would like to ask you your journey with writing. So far now this is your second book. Are there any tips or advices you would like to give to other writers or other authors or to be authors that what helped you to write these books? I mean, this is something that is personal to you as well, because you already know, you have the knowledge and everything. So this is non-fiction. This is actually a guide, a factual book kind of book. What would you suggest tips for people who write your genre of books?
I love that question. Why? I'll tell you, because I read somewhere it says write a book that you would like to read, right? So that's the reason I write books, which I, you know, when I was 25, I had my first child, I was wondering, where can I look up to, whom can I look up to and get some stuff? Which is like, as you said, first time parent is always a most confused parent. And then they are doing all kinds of trials and, you know, errors to bring up the first child. And it's a very, very, I must tell you, because psychologically also we are not equipped. This is our first experience. So overall, the whole journey is very difficult. So please write on a subject which is, which you know can help ease somebody else's burden. That's one. Secondly, I never wanted to write fiction simply because I don't feel I'm too good at that. But by virtue of my work and by virtue of whatever I've learned as a mother, I feel that's my gift and my contribution to the parenting community, as well as anybody who's a nurturer. Because, you know, when we think of children, when we think
guardians.
Of young adults,
it's all guardians.
Future. Yeah, yeah, guardians, absolutely. So, and I also say, if you are leading a team, right, then also it's a very important thing, because a team is like your children. So when you're a professional leading a team and you are not imbibing those qualities, why would your team model you or look up to you?
Yeah.
So my humble suggestion to everybody who wants to write a book is, number one, write on something which is so close to your heart. Because possibly when you write on topics like this, you know, I'm 100% sure they are going to either challenge some status quo, or they would be giving solutions to something.
They will definitely relate to someone. Because we have like a 7 billion,
yes.
7 billion zillion of population. It will relate to someone or someone else, you know.
That's there for sure. But then if you look at it, which target audience actually needs you the most and your expertise most? I feel because I'm into this area of work, I have seen parents. I have seen how parents are going, berserk, trying to, you know, just mold the child, but not molding themselves.
They themselves get irritated.
They have a lot of things, actually. They are restless. They are restless. They have big ambitions and they have so much to handle in a single day. So I would say, please make that journey easier for your reader is one thing which every author should look at. Secondly, bring some very, very practical and doable stuff on the table. Because it's one thing about writing very difficult books and all the amazing content. But if you're not able to kind of filter it in a manner that they can use, I don't think there's a point. So for me, my most important thing is I really resonated with this concept of raising the parent. Yeah. Because raising the children, I'm doing already. Raising the parent, if even, 100 or 600 parents go through this and they are evolving themselves.
Pragati, it was a pleasure talking to you. I'm sorry I took so much of your time. And I think while we were conversing, it already stretched to a longer period of time. But thank you for your time today. It was a pleasure having you. And it was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much. Parenting in itself is a topic which would need that kind of time, I guess. But whatever little we've given, I'm happy that we've talked about it. And let's hope this book actually is able to connect with the audience in ways that it delivers solutions and it is practically usable. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Bye-bye.